Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and many people ask me every day, if I want to install an iOS beta, how will I then upgrade to the final version once it's finally released? And many of you are nice enough to help those people out in comments, but I get asked this question enough that I thought I'd explain it in a short video. And so let me explain a couple things of how they did it with previous versions of iOS prior to their public release. And what they normally do is if you are on iOS betas, iOS 13 beta or public beta, what they normally do is about a few days to a week prior to the final release to the public, they'll actually push what's called a GM or a Golden Master or Gold Master for short. People will actually receive that update by going to Settings, General, and Software Update while enrolled into the public beta or developer beta, and you'll get that GM update. And what that is the final release that Apple thinks is good enough for the public to be pushed out to the public a little bit later. And as long as it's good enough, what they'll do is they'll just push that out as the final release. And so what that means for beta testers is normally you only have to delete the beta profile. So if you're a beta tester, you're familiar with the profile, you actually have to install the profile in order to be a beta tester. So to remove yourself from the beta tester program, once the final is released, you'll have that GM or final version. Then you'll just go to General. Then you'll go down to Profile, tap on the profile, and then hit Remove Profile. Reboot your phone. That's usually a good idea. You don't necessarily have to do that, but reboot your phone and you'll be on the final version. And that's normally indicated by the actual build number found under About in Settings. And the reason I give the build number in many of my update or in all of my update videos is so that we know which version we're actually on. So what happens? They push the last version to you or the GM version to you a little bit early. You get to play around with it, see if there's any bugs or major bugs that they need to fix prior to the release. As long as there's nothing, they push the same exact version to the public with the same exact build number. And that's how we know when it's a GM or that's the final release. So if you have that, you're good to go. Now, if they do it differently, which they have sometimes, but not normally with major releases, all you'll do is go to Settings, go to General, Software Update, and install the last update. Then you can remove that profile if you don't want to receive betas anymore. It's really that simple. There's not anything more to it, and you won't need anything to downgrade. Now, you will have to upgrade through the betas, or you could remove the profile now, and then when the final comes out, you'll be able to install it. But I would suggest keeping that beta profile for now, waiting until the final version, the GM, is released. And then when the final version is out, then you can do as I said before. You won't need iTunes or anything like that. You won't lose any data by removing that profile. I just don't suggest removing the profile unless you're using iTunes to completely wipe and restore your phone back to a previous version. So that's it. Hopefully that helps you out and helps answer any of those questions. If you have any other questions or anything you want to ask on how to do, if it's something I get a lot, I'll make another video about it and let you know. But let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.